I'm R.
I'm Saint.
I'm Q.
And this is the Need to Know. So guys, we have two wonderful guests, and we're gonna let them introduce themselves, and then we're gonna get into our topic.
My name's Saint. I'm the best artist in New York. I'm allowed to say that though. Yeah.
I'm Q. Another way of saying Queens0riginal. I'm pretty much a fashion designer and a marketer.
So today's topic, we're talking about personal growth, and then we're gonna do. It's basically gonna fall into an interview. It all just gonna sum up everything. So, for starters, we could talk about where you started, like, and how you got into, you know, FiveStar.
I basically just started on SoundCloud, pretty much like everybody else. I didn't really have a direction on where I wanted to go with it. I actually just started FiveStar because I noticed a lot of artists weren't getting the amount of money they're supposed to get. There's a whole controversial, you know, topic on the industry, especially the music industry. But I really just wanted to take control of what I wanted to do. I wanted to build something special with family, and that's where I started FiveStar.
Alright, so in terms of personal growth, what do you guys feel like you are now versus, like, let's say 5 years ago?
We're new. We started last year, but compared to when we first started, like, it was kind of just an idea. It started out as three of us. Some people stayed, some people had other obligations that they had to fulfill. But we're pretty much just learning. Like, we're still learning. We were just outside, you know, when we were walking, we were just talking about business, and there's always more to learn. You know, we're just starting out, we're independent, but we're trying to be big, so you gotta understand the ins and outs, you know what I mean? But yeah.
Alright, so to follow up on that, what are your 5 goals for the next 6 months to the year?
Well, I can start off with having assets that will just pay off the houses of my parents. Sure. Making sure I have my own company as well and successful. Besides being part of FiveStar, making sure FiveStar is really successful as well. That's 3. And just be the best of me, really. That's 4. I can't really think of that one. Be healthy. Healthier than that.
That's true. My biggest goal. Everything, I plan everything out, like, way ahead of time. So my next 5 goals are to complete my personal studio. We're in the process of building that right now. Secondly, is to get a successful merchandise line going. That's also in the works. 3, my third one, probably help my mom move. My mom is not moving. So, basically what he said, basically using your assets, not just money that comes in, but using something that is within you. So, yeah, you're cheaper and pay for that. Using that to help my mom, definitely want to have at least an hour. Outside of that, there isn't really anybody that has a really big brand or anything that we're working with right now. Down the line, we're open to it. We're down to collab, but at the same time, we want to keep our brand very, yeah.
I think you guys like kind of touched upon it, but like what exactly does your brand represent? So like what is FiveStar mainly focused on?
Just the main thing about it is just between family, loyalty, communication, just being the best of you, like whatever's past, like most of the time the people that are in FiveStar, they've had their rough life.
That goes into the energy that we put out to others as well, because when you put out that positive energy towards others, you know, they'll give it to the next person, and so on and so forth. So we just want to be that label, that family, that group that like exudes them.
So how does social media benefit your brand?
Well, one thing for sure is, in general, it's like a platform. Our brand, I mean, that's one of the keys for brand awareness nowadays. So like, us being able to like reach out to so many different artists, because I always use social media as well, it makes it a lot easier to do. Still hard, but it makes things less complicated just because you're out there and you need to touch. And besides that too, you know, like just between my artists, just making sure that I'm fully remembered right now.
Nowadays, more than ever, everyone individually has their own brand. Like when you look on somebody's page, like even someone that doesn't really do anything, they can have their brand. And that really goes a long way, because now there's people that don't do anything, they have a lot of followers, they get paid for like promotion, et cetera. So there's a lot of opportunities that come through, you know, the social media network, because a lot of the time, especially in New York, it's a big place.
Right.
And you can, you know, be following somebody and pass them on the street and not even know. But when you see them, or they see you, and, you know, for example, FiveStar shirt or a piece of merchandise, they can literally see that. And then on top of seeing that, they can just scroll up and then go to a website and then, you know, just check out anything you want to check out.
From what I'm hearing, that's the design of marketing shirt. But what about word of mouth?
Which one
do you think
is
better, word of mouth or
just
social media?
I'm gonna say my opinion, you can say it. But I'd say mouth, direct marketing is probably the best.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can really communicate with the person and really see who they are and what I am as well.
Right.
And there, you could have something special and throw something in there. So yeah, I think mouth, for sure.
For me, it's still the number one form of marketing today. I think it's a lot more difficult for people because everyone's this all the time. But when you really know how to network and just create relationships with people, it's a lot different. Doing that in person is a lot better than doing it behind the screen in, you know, in any situation.
like number one marketing strategy. Like you said, like you can see somebody wearing something, you're like, oh snap, I want that. But you know, eventually, like, where did you get that from?
Right.
That's
right,
like,
right.
Oh, so can you go to the store? Can you buy it online? Right. And it's like that spark of a conversation is just what gets you to. So I have a few more because I have mad questions. But so I know before you did music, you was a part of it. I do know, but that was the question. So I was like, how was that transition from that into
it was actually pretty interesting because I kind of realized that in order for me to really craft my sound and learn how to produce my own beats and learn how to, you know, write better than I did at the time, I had to really put in that time. And pretty much being a party promoter is like sometimes Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays, sometimes Sundays, and it's like 3 to 5 days a week, you out till like 4 in the morning. And then when you go home, it's like sometimes 6. You go to sleep at 6 in the morning, you sleep till like 5 p.m. and then it just starts all over again. So I kind of took a step away from that to focus more on music. But all the connections that I did make in that scene, like I'm still cool with a lot of people in that scene. So now, in terms of networking, if you know, I want to go to a party, see who's popping at the party, you know, I have people that, you know, I'm familiar with, that's part of the conversation. It definitely makes it a lot easier to network. A lot easier to get your songs played too. That's a huge advantage.
How is that though? Like getting your music played? Because I went to one event and like this guy paid to have his song never played.
And
we was there all night waiting for that song to get played. Did not get played. Like, we were like,
it's
crazy.
I mean, you can pay DJs to actually, you know, play your music and everything like that. That's actually what Amigos used to do when we were first on the come up. Sometimes, like you said, I guess it just doesn't work out like that. But for the most part, it's either you have to pay or, you know, they just do it off of love. So, you know, people that know me personally, they'll, you know, do it for the love. Or if anything, if they want me to throw them something, I'll throw them something because, you know, that's love. But it's not that hard. It's really just about, you know, getting next to the right people and actually, you know, being open about, like, okay, can you actually, you know, voice that to that person instead of just, you know, standing in the corner and just, like,
So, in terms of personal growth, what do you think is the most difficult aspect of it? Like, you know how everybody's life is different. You know, some people may have situations that worse, but what do you think is like that number one key that can benefit anybody to get through what they're doing?
First of all, like for me, for example, I like work ethic a lot. Work ethic. I didn't know I didn't have a passion during that time. Because during that, like my young life, I didn't really know where I was headed. Had a lot of anxiety, depression, a lot of stuff going on between my family and stuff like that. And I didn't really have that perfect mindset. So like, just for me, like being able to like fix that really changed everything.
And if I want to do something and I want to be taken seriously for it, lot of it is really being accountable to yourself. And just keeping it established with yourself at all times. Like, you know, did I really give, you know, my all in that basketball game? Or did I really give my all in that performance? Or even if I'm, like, recording, like, did I really give my all in that last take? It's really just about, you know, putting yourself in someone else's shoes and saying, all right, I'm looking at myself now. Is that the person that I'm trying to be? Am I doing the right thing from day to day? But yeah, that's really what it's about. A lot of it is also about getting out of your comfort zone. That's one thing that we were actually talking about too. Like, just getting outside of, like, okay, I hang with these people and these are my friends and, you know, we just hang out all the time, everything like that. Like, if you're comfortable, that's usually why you're not feeling, if that makes sense. Usually when you're uncomfortable, when you're doing something new, when you're developing a skill set, when you're learning something, that's when you're actually doing it. I think that's like one of the biggest things. That makes up accountability and just having a discipline to stay with it. Because a lot of the times, like, you can try to change and doesn't work out, and people, you know, they hear you, they'll say whatever they're gonna say, but you just gotta stick with it. You gotta be yourself, but you gotta stick with it. But yeah, that's what we're doing.
So, in terms of personal growth,
just like nobody in my family actually made it so far in the point of my life, even if it was high school or even middle school. And that kind of affected me in a way, made me think different, made me say that I want to be completely different. And on top of that, although my family didn't really make it so far, it's just the fact that they had so much love and like courage and like to push me at least to be doing something. And it's like seeing that made me be pushed.
Honestly, blood doesn't necessarily make you family, in my opinion. I feel like anybody that really gives me money is my family, and I'm trying to give them a thousand money. Basically, anybody that's, you know, there with me, like, this is my brother right here. Like, he's not blood, but this is my brother. Like, his family is my family, and I want the best for them. So I know that, you know, I can go through the struggle for my kids, but they don't have to go through that. I want my kids to be born rich. I don't want them to have the same problems that, you know, I face. I don't want them to go through the same things that I went through. I don't want them to have to learn the lessons the hard way that I learned and that, you know, my parents and their parents learned. So I just really want to do it for my family. I also want to do it for the culture. I know that might sound funny, but actually, like, I feel like as a black community, as a Latino community, we could do a lot better sticking with our own minorities as, you know, as a whole. I think we could really take advantage of the opportunities that social media present. You could really have a business, you could have your own brand, and it's easier than ever to, you know, do what you want to do. Like, for example, there's like this gamer guy, Ninja. Plays Fortnite, that's what it's called. Nah, but like he be doing his thing, he's playing Fortnite, and like he gets sponsorships off that, and he gets paid for great amount of money. So it's really easy. It's just sticking with it, and persevering is the key, because a lot of the times, like, even Cause I really live in confusion. I'm like, damn, like I really want to see like all my goals. Like I really want to see them smiling. Like I want to see everybody get rich and happy. But that's really what makes me going. Because if I don't do this now today, a couple months from now, that's the difference. It's not like, oh, I'm going to get lucky. It's about, am I putting in the work today to reap the benefits tomorrow? And just doing that from day to day and being happy through the process and enjoying the process, that's really what patience is. Not like, oh, I have to do this to fail. That mentality is really what patience is. You have to enjoy the process and understand that, you know, it might come tomorrow, but then again, it might come this year. But you still have the same amount of joy in what you're doing, especially if you're passionate about it. So just putting my all in and letting my family reap the benefits of that.
You said no? Okay, so we're gonna talk about my favorite question now. Okay. So guys, what is your top five?
Okay, alright. I was like, alright. You
I'll be free little dirt because he dead in jail.
You be like,
gotta be dead.
It changed every episode. We ask this question, it's never the same. Like, it's never the same. Oh, but yeah, that's fine. What's crazy?
Juice World?
Yeah, Juice World's fire. What are you talking about? So, I'm trying to think what to do. Do you guys have
anything else to say? Not really. Just besides, like, whatever you want to do, do it. Find your passion. Find the reason why you're going to do it. Mm-hmm. And if your dream is not scaring you, then you're not dreaming big enough. So just follow it.
And support is key, guys. Like they said, like, yeah, you guys have to support each other, even if it's small, even if it's big, even if it's... Right, it doesn't matter. You know, support is a big thing. Like, I tell Shema all the time, you know, I'm really big on the support thing. Like, I'm like, you got to. And, you know, even if it's a small circle, it's a small circle, you know? That's a gateway I gotta get with small circles.
Just to kind of piggyback on that, support is about what you can do for others. It's not about getting back something. True support is not about, you know, helping somebody out or shouting somebody out so that they can do the same for you. They'll come back. You know, positivity in the universe comes back. So real support is showing love just off the strength of the fact that you want to show love. So make sure that when you're supporting somebody, look to yourself and understand why you're supporting them.
Queens0riginal. My Instagram is Queens0riginal with a 0. And just pretty much follow FiveStar record label. Literally FiveStar record label, if you know how to spell that.
The boy is Saint here. You can follow me at Pray for Saints. Make sure y'all follow me on Instagram. I do follow that.
Alright, y'all, that was the end of the show. Shout out to our lovely guests, Queens0riginal and Saint, for coming on the show. As you guys may or may not know, the season is coming to a close very soon. If you do want to be part of the show, email us or DM us.
We got open dates.
Yeah, we got open dates available for June. So, yeah, even you don't have to be like a music artist. You don't have to be anything. You could be a regular person just chilling out. If you want to be in the show, come through, email us, DM us as soon as possible, because once June's over,
That's it.
Yeah,
my show comes out in August, guys.
Make sure you stay tuned. But until next episode, you guys can follow me on Instagram and Twitter @ We Want More.
You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter @WeTheHost. And make sure you follow the Wonderful Shows page at TNTK Show on Instagram and Twitter, guys. We have a Twitter. As always, make sure you like, you comment, you share, subscribe. Bye, guys.